Hey guys, Drifter here. Welcome to World War II In Depth. In today's episode, I want to talk to you about some sway problems. And I'm going to clarify that this is going to be a really in-depth episode. We're going very far into some minutiae that I didn't plan to get into, but I found this to be extremely problematic. And I think that the solutions that I'm going over are going to be very important in the pro scene and in the public scene, because the sway in this game is doing some very unusual things. I was kind of testing it out for attachments and stances, and what I noticed is when I aim down sights with the M1 Garand, it pulled to the side. Now, you probably didn't notice that, so I'll do it again closer. You notice that after I aim down sights, it tugs to the side really quick and then just kind of stops for no reason. Now, the M1 basically doesn't pull, so I'll show you on the bar. The bar sways a lot more. When you aim down sights with the bar, it'll sway to one side really quickly and then resume normal sway, but it almost immediately kicks off to the side after a brief moment of non-sway, and it does the exact same thing on some machine guns. It's a really strange mechanic to have the first instance still and then the second instance fast and then back to normal sway. And I think it's going to really mess up a lot of people's aim. So to clarify on what's going on here, when you aim down sights, your weapon won't sway initially. It'll be perfectly steady for a fraction of a second. And then the first bit of sway is going to be very harsh, and it's going to pull to one side or the other very hard and throw off your aim. And then it's going to normalize and resume its normal sway pattern that you can kind of compensate for. But the three things happening all very quickly is very strange to me. And I was wondering why I was having such a difficult time aiming with the bar and with some of the submachine guns. For me, this can be incredibly annoying, and it can really mess up your aim at long ranges. Doing something at long range with the bar, with the FG-42, trying to map somebody with the grease gun or PPSH, it's very difficult when there's no consistent sway pattern or when you've got to mentally adjust for three different ones. I thought I was just bad at aiming, but no, this is a real problem. Unfortunately, the sort of stair-stepping sway doesn't have a true solution because it's coded into the game. There's no way around that. However, I did find some very interesting sway reduction methods. First of all, submachine guns have a lot of idle sway. You can see it in all the test footage of the other submachine guns. I'll show you more test footage of the WAF. When you aim down sights with that one, it does the same thing, the fast pull to the side, and just generally a lot of idle sway. I tested all the submachine guns, and I generally found that idle sway is completely unaffected by optics. There's only two optics you can put on SMGs anyway, and they have no effect whatsoever on the sway, so they're just going to sway almost no matter what, but I do have another mitigation technique later on. When it comes to assault rifles, I found it unusual that some of them have significant sway and some of them do not. One of the ones I was surprised do not have significant sway is the M1941 Johnson, the very fast-firing full-auto weapon. It basically doesn't sway, which is kind of strange. However, the STG-44 sways a little bit, the FG-42 sways a little bit more, and the bar sways a lot. It's very significant. If you want a quick list, the ones that have significant sway that you need to worry about are the STG, the FG, and the bar. The other ones, the M1A1, the SVT Soviet weapon, you know, the M1 Garand and the Johnson, they don't really have sway, so you don't have to worry about it very much. That's a nice thing. However, I did find that adding a 4X optic reduces the sway by about 95%. Here is the STG-44 again, and you can see that with the 4X optic, there is essentially no sway on it, maybe a super tiny amount. I would say a negligible amount. And the bar, which sways a lot when I put a 4X optic on it, now sways so little I had to really eyeball to see that it was doing anything at all. So adding a 4X optic to any gun on which the sway is annoying is nice. It seems to very significantly reduce it. I'm estimating about 95%. And for the submachine guns, there's one other trick you can do. I'm going to show you with the PPSH here, and you can see when I aim down sights, I'm going to do it a few times because I'm kind of lining it up on that bar, it'll sway. However, if I decide to crouch or prone out, especially when I go prone, the amount of idle sway on the gun goes to almost zero. It's a 90-95% reduction on the idle sway, and the same thing applies to assault rifles and light machine guns. If your gun's swaying a lot, you can reduce it about by half if you want to crouch, and you can almost completely eliminate it if you have the opportunity to prone out. So overall, the summary of this episode is SMGs are going to sway a lot, about half of the ARs. The sway pattern has this goofy, very still, fast, and then normal, which kind of screws up your aim. And the easiest way to fix it is probably to crouch or prone. In the public matches, I don't know how much difference it's going to make. In competitive matches, I think it can make a very big difference, especially if people want to anchor with the bar and hold it down. That kind of goofy kick will be hard when people aim down sights. And if they want to crouch or go prone out, they can completely remove the sway and aim better. Guys, that is all for this in-depth episode. I hope you learned something useful. If you did, don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe. Drifter out.